Suffering has no value. And when I make this claim, I'm really only echoing a contention made by Nietzsche, that is, that there are no moral phenomena, only the moral interpretation of
them. So he didn't say the word value, but it doesn't really matter, right? Maybe he did say the word value, but the point is, we will never be able to have a conversation. So you can argue all you want, but if we're going to argue apples and oranges, or we're going to argue dark matter and matter, I mean, there's just no point in having a conversation. If you can't concede that the existence of a sentient creature in and of itself creates a value entity, there is now a welfare in the universe when you have a sentient. If I create one sentient being, little feeling rabbit, and that's all there was, this little rabbit in the universe, in a little plastic bubble, you're going to tell me there's no value in the universe, that little fluffy rabbit's welfare is not valuable? Nietzsche says so. You're going to discount the welfare of its sentient existence because Nietzsche told you so. You're going to deny the fact that it has a functional, conscious brain capable of manifesting sensations, and that those sensations don't have any meaning because you're not around to say so, or Nietzsche's not around to say it doesn't matter. Man, I mean, it's just pathetic. You go along with this Nietzsche shit? You do? You go along with this crap that we decide. We just get to make it up. The rabbit doesn't really mean anything. It's just made out of plastic. It wouldn't matter. If I made the rabbit out of plastic or I made a real rabbit, it wouldn't matter to Nietzsche. Nietzsche says it's the same goddamn thing. Plastic rabbit in the bubble, real live rabbit, conscious experiencing rabbit in the bubble. Same difference. Doesn't fucking matter. You think that's the truth of it? You think that's the reality we exist in? God, I just don't know what to say. I mean, you people are dumber than five-year-old kids.
Well, I'll proceed by way of analogy. Most anti-nihilists tend to be determinists.
Yeah, well, most rational, intelligent people have to concede the determinism, because as soon as you say, well, what would be the undetermining factor? Oh, that's right. There isn't any. Magic dust? The super forces? Well, what's the magic force of non-determinism? There's a little man inside of my brain pulling levers, and he's deciding that it's not deterministic. He's not part of the universe. He's acting independently. He's not being bombarded by radiation and photons and energy, and he didn't have to go to school to learn how to pull the levers inside my brain. You have no choice. If you're educated and rational, you've got to concede.
In and of itself has a kind of redeeming quality. And I would say that perhaps the anti-natalist is right. Don't have children until we know how to love one another.
Well, if you're going to wait till you can do that, then yeah, good, I win.